Hi friends, welcome to EduTap. A very pleasant good evening. So today we'll be having a quick look at some of the important questions taken from the current affairs part in specific focus to agriculture. Right, so we are having a session here for your NABARD Development Assistant Mains Examination 2019, right? And this particular session is going to help you out for your tomorrow's examination, wherein you have 50 marks which is being asked for your from your general awareness part, right? So now if you see this particular session, we'll quickly concentrate on the current affairs related questions, right? And in case you can, if you want, you can watch the session later as well. So what I'll be doing is I'll be quickly taking the question and immediately I'll be giving you the answer so that this video can act as a revision for you guys, right? And yesterday we had taken the session wherein we had certain important MCQs, but they were not having special focus on current affairs, okay? So that's what we're going to be doing right now. So let me quickly begin and you can also have a look at these questions at a later point of time, right? So if you can hear me properly, if my voice is audible, just you can write down in the comment section and I'll quickly begin with the session as well, right? So here the first question that you can see on your screen, it says that recently the government of India has relaxed mandatory Aadhaar seeding for which of the following scheme? And you can see there are five options there and all of the schemes are quite confusing, but we need to see in the context of the current affairs. So basically the answer for this particular question is PM Kisan scheme, right? And then moving forward to the next question on your screen. So it says which of the following day is being celebrated for the first time, okay? So I can see Aditya Jamwal joining in. Thank you Aditya for giving me a cue. Hi Shubhodeep. So since not many of your friends are here, still we will continue with the session and I'll keep telling the questions and I would expect answers from you guys, right? And the correct answer here, it is World Cotton Day, right? Okay, moving forward, how much area is currently covered under the micro irrigation by the year 2018-19? Now, this is again important one, right? So, is it 12.28, 11.58, 5.83 or 5.75 or 10 lakh hectare, okay? So, quickly tell me the answer for this. Anyway, I'll just give you 1 or 2 seconds and then I'll flip the question. So the right one here, it is 11.58 lakh hectares, okay? Moving ahead, so the fourth question is regarding the fill in the blanks. So here it says the state government of Dash and the World Bank have signed $165 million loan agreement to strengthen smallholder farmers, okay? So you can see a very simple question. The right answer here is Odisha. Okay, so I can see a few people answering. So I can see hi Kishore, hi Somnath, hi Lokesh, hi Vini. So all of you are giving the answers. Great going. Next, the fifth question on your screen. The first ever India International Cooperative Trade Fair will commence from 11th of October 2019 at which place in India? Okay, so all this these questions are taken in context of the current affairs with regard to agriculture, right? So the correct answer here is Delhi. Next, International Day of Rural Women is observed on which date? So the correct answer here is it is observed on the 15th of October. Okay. Next, in which state of India, Prakritik Kheti Kushal Kisan scheme has been launched recently? Okay, so these are state specific schemes as well. So the answer here is Himachal Pradesh. Moving forth, researchers have discovered new species of eel loach named Pangyo Bhujia in which state of India? So basically this is a freshwater fish, okay, belonging to the category of loach. And the answer here is Kerala. Next, Saras Ajivika Mela is an initiative of which of the following ministry? So the answer here, it is Ministry of Rural Development. Next, what is the name of the satellite-based advisory service that has been launched for seamless and effective dissemination of emergency information and communication and disaster warnings, potential fishing zones and ocean states forecast to fishermen? So the right answer here is Gemini. Next, if you see, what is the MSP of wheat for the year 2020-21? Okay, so these kind of MSP based questions are very prone to come because you have specific focus on agriculture if you talk about general awareness section, right? So all memory based questions. The right answer here is rupees 1925. So here you can see the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs chaired by the Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi, has approved the increase in MSP for all mandated Rabi crops of 2019-20 to be marketed in the Rabi marketing season. So the MSP has been issued on 23rd of October. So very recent, and this is again important question. Star mark this. Next. For which of the following Rabi crops, current MSP has shown maximum increase over the period, previous season MSP? Okay, so MSP related questions are going to be there in your paper. The right answer here is lentil. So for Rabi crops, you can see here the highest increase in MSP has been recommended for lentil, followed by safflower and gram. Okay. Next, how much provision has been made in the budget 2019-20 for eco-friendly management of crop residue? So the right answer here is 1140, that is 1140 crores have been allocated for eco-friendly management of crop residue. Next, which of the following model of integrated farming system is being suggested as most profitable for the areas having rainfall between 700 to 1100 mm? So the right answer here is horticulture livestock. Next, in which state maximum number of mandis are registered on ENAM? So the right answer is Uttar Pradesh. Next, ICRISAT tied up with which company in September 2019 to help 6,000 riyots turn entrepreneurs, that is farmers we are referring to here. So the right answer is Farmer Producer Company. So guys, keep mentioning the answers in the comment section. You can write the entire answer very quickly. I'm flipping the questions fast so that we can finish the session in a short period so that you can revise it later. Okay, so I want you to write the answers there. Next, according to a study published in Nature Climate Change, continued global warming could lower the banana yield, leading to a drop of 0.59 to 0.19 tons per hectare by which year? So the right answer here is by the year 2050. Next question, it is called Una Samruddhi mobile app. It was launched in which state? Okay, so even state related initiatives or portals or apps also can be asked in your paper. So the right answer here is Kerala. Next, the central government has decided to give special training to workers under the Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act or scheme. All these training will be given at. So where will the training be provided? So the right answer here is Krishi Vigyan Kendra. Next, Prime Minister Mr. Narendra Modi has launched the National Animal Disease Control Program for eradicating the foot and mouth disease and brucellosis in the livestock on September at which place? So basically in September, sorry. So which place has this particular initiative been launched? So try attempting the answers for these questions. Tomorrow you might expect questions from these that we are discussing today. So it's going to help you out in remembering. So the answer is Mathura, Uttar Pradesh. Next, National Animal Disease Control Program launched in September 2019 has the aim of eradicating the foot and mouth disease and brucellosis by which year? So the right answer here is by the year 2030. Now, Prime Minister Mr. Narendra Modi shall launch the Kisan Mandhan Yojana on the 12th of September at which place? So answers please quickly in the chat section below. So the answer is Ranchi, Jharkhand. Next, Union Minister of State for Agriculture and Farmers Welfare has launched a multilingual mobile app for crop residue management, which is named what? So the right answer is CHC Farm Machinery. The straw burning events in 2018 have reduced by dash and dash as compared to that in 2017 and 2016 respectively. So a very prominent issue, straw burning. So right answer is 15% and 41% respectively. Government has imposed minimum export price for onions at how much USD per metric ton? So all these are memory based, no concepts related here. So you can directly memorize these answers, and it is USD 850 per metric ton. Next, the government provides financial assistance up to how much rupees per mega food park project? So I can see Utsav has joined in. So hi Utsav. Let's see if all of you are answering these questions that we are discussing. So the answer here is 50 crore. The World Bank has announced at the 15th Indo-US Economic Summit that it will provide assistance of how much money to food parks in India. So again, the question is related to food parks. So the right answer here is rupees 3000 crore. 15th Indo-US Economic Summit has taken place in which place, in which location? So the right answer here is New Delhi. An agri-tech platform, Dehat, has signed a memorandum of understanding with which among the following to work with lychee farmers in India. Now, this is important. Okay. So, these questions are very easy, but you know, sometimes we tend to not cover them. But since there is a special reference to agriculture, it is important that we do these questions. The answer is Coca-Cola India. Which state government has recently passed a new scheme called Dues Recovery and Settlement Scheme 2019-20? So the right answer here is Punjab. The current bill of the government for the import of edible oils is how much per year? So the right answer is 60,000 crore per year. Oilseeds production has gone up from 25.1 million tons during 2003 to 4 to around how much during 2018-19? So the right answer here is 32.26 million tons. Pulse production in India has risen from 16.3 million tons in 2015-16 to how many tons in 17-18, which is an increase of 55% over 3 years. So it's huge, 55% increase. The answer is 25.42 million tons. Next, which is the first among dairy cooperatives that has acquired the central registration for the brand owner under the Central Pollution Control Board in line with the Waste Plastic Waste Management Amendment Rule 2018 and has got the license? And the answer here is Mother Dairy. Which among the following variety has been developed by the Indian Institute of Horticultural Research exclusively meant for the processing industry? This is an important question. And the right one here is both 2 and 3, that is Arka Vishesh and Arka Apeksha. So I can see few people like Lokesh, Chubodeep, Kans and Vinita. All these they are answering regularly. So it's really good that you're practicing these questions. Who has been elected as a chairman of International Egg Commission for the next 2 years? So the answer is Suresh Chitrui. International Egg Commission is a global network for the egg industry and it is based in. So it is based in London. So Atul Chaturvedi has been re-elected as the president of the Solvent Extractors Association of India for a term of how many years? Okay, so I can see Mayank coming in. Great, you're answering. Surya Prasad is also answering. Great. So the answer here is 3 years. The Solvent Extractors Association of India was formed in which year? So the answer is 1963. Agricultural company Syngenta has set up an innovations and learning center at which place? Okay, so we are talking about a very important company, Syngenta. So the right answer here is Andhra Pradesh. The 15th session of the South Asian Seasonal Climate Outlook Forum has taken place in the month of September 2019 at which place of Kerala? So a lot of questions on venue. So the answer is Thiruvananthapuram, the capital of it. The South Asian Seasonal Climate Outlook Forum was established in which year? So the right answer here is 2010. So not that old, it is recent. PM Kisan Yojana provides how many annual payout, how much annual payout to farmers in 3 equal installments? So this is important, PM Kisan Yojana. So there are 3 installments in total. So the answer is 6,000, right? So this is just star mark this particular question, guys. As per the first advance estimates released by the Agriculture Ministry recently, India's food grains production during the rain-fed Kharif season is estimated at what? So we are talking about the food grain production. So the right answer is 140.57 million tons. Next, a new variety of ladyfinger, Kashi Lalima, has been recently developed by the scientist of which organization? This is important. So whenever new varieties are out, we need to know which organization has actually released that particular variety. So the correct answer here is Indian Institute of Vegetable Research. Next, Pusa Chickpea 10216 is a type of which? What is it variety? Okay, so it's very important. These kind of questions are very easy to do. So just memorize them then and there. The answer is drought tolerant. From the month of October 2019, farmers can avail solar water pumps from which scheme on the basis of Aadhaar card? So which scheme are we talking about in this particular question? So the right answer is Kusum. Next, Pradhan Mantri Kisan Urja Suraksha Evam Uttam Mahabhiyan scheme for farmers has been launched by which ministry? So we are talking about PM Kusum scheme and we are referring to which ministry takes care of this particular scheme. So the right answer here is Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. Next, to install solar panels under the Kusum scheme, farmers have to pay how much percentage of the total cost of the equipment? This is important. So the answer is 10% of the total cost of the equipment needs to be paid by the farmers. Okay, so I can see Priyanka Kumari also chipping in with her answer, so it's great. Next, the 50th question, guys. So new protein rich variety HD3226 is referred to as what? Okay, so what is the name of this particular variety? So the answer is Pusa Yashasvi. Next, PM Kusum scheme aims to add solar and other renewable capacity of 25,750 megawatt by which year? So the right answer is by the year 2022. Next, two superior chickpea varieties, Pusa Chickpea 10216 and Super Anigiri 1 have been developed by which institute? Okay, or which organization? So the right answer here is all of the above. So all of the above are involved in developing two superior chickpea varieties, that's Pusa Chickpea 10216 and Super Anigiri 1. So Kashi Lalima, a newly developed variety of ladyfinger is of which color instead of green? So just now we saw this particular question. It was regarding which is a new ladyfinger variety here. Okay, now you need to tell me the color of this particular variety. So the right answer is red. Okay, so instead of green, it is red. Cumulatively, the loan dispersed to the government of Assam by NABARD stood at rupees dash up to March 31st, 2019. So the right answer is ₹4,877.67 crore. Okay, so this is the loan dispersed by the government of Assam to the government of Assam by NABARD. National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development has sanctioned around 3,520 projects worth how many rupees for the state of Assam till March 31st, 2019. So I think it's the same kind of a question. Let's see. It is okay. It is 7,019.47 crore. Next, recently in the month of November 2019, which of the following investment banks has announced that it will stop funding fossil fuel projects at the end of 2021? This is important. So the right answer is European Investment Bank. Project Safal is related to which of the following insect pests? Now this question is important. Star mark this question. We are talking about Project Safal. So the right answer here is fall armyworm. Next, an exclusive user and farmers friendly website on fall armyworm is developed by. So you need to tell me the answer. Who has developed it? So the right answer here is South Asia Biotechnology Center. Next, which state is going to undertake the large-scale mapping of village Gautan Abadi areas by using drones? And the right answer is Maharashtra. Next, the country's total honey production reported in 2017-18 was how much? So we are talking about the total honey production reported in 2017-18. The answer is 1.05 lakh metric tons. Next, lakh cultivation in India is mainly confined to which state? This is important. We are talking about lakh cultivation. The answer is all of the above. Okay, so Jharkhand, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra. So all these states you would find lakh cultivation. For the first time in India, Mission 1 Million Fruit Tree Plantation Project has been launched in which state? So we are talking about Mission 1 Million Fruit Tree Plantation. And the right answer here is Odisha. SugarTech 2019 was held on 19th of September in, so which place was it held? The right one is Lucknow. India ranks at which position in sugarcane production in the world? Again, very important. So the right answer is second. National Conference on Risk Mitigation through Tech Innovations and Agri-Insurance in August 2019 was organized by which organization? So the answer is Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industry. So guys, try writing the answers in the chat section. At least you'll remember those answers. So which agricultural university has produced liquid fertilizer from the human hair waste? Again, something very unique. So the right answer is Kerala Agricultural University. Who is the present Union Petroleum Minister of India? The right answer is Shri Dharmendra Pradhan. Uber for Tractors app is related to which agricultural equipment? So this is important, guys. Star mark this particular question. It is called Uber for Tractors app. So this is a very probable question for tomorrow's exam, and the answer is levelers. A rare variety of tea from Assam has set a new record as it has been auctioned for dash per kg at the Guwahati Tea Auction Center. So I think the name is Golden Butterfly. Yes, it is. So how much, what is the amount? How much it is being sold for? And the answer is ₹75,000. So yes, it is the Golden Butterfly. It belongs to Upper Assam's Dikom Tea Estate. It is sold at ₹75,000 per kg. Okay, so this is again a probable question. Registration for the PM Kisan Mandhan Yojana has started from, okay? So we are talking about again a very important scheme. And the answer is August 2019. Assam tea industry is the single largest employer of women because dash percentage of workers are women. Okay, so this is again a very important question. Assam tea industry we are talking about. And the answer is 50% of workers there are women. So again, that's the reason it is the single largest employer of women in terms of tea industries if you talk about. Report AgriTech in India, Emerging Trends in 2019, released by NASSCOM, has found the AgriTech sector in India is growing at a rate of what? Okay, so we are talking about the AgriTech sector here. So the right answer is 25% year on year. Okay, so that's nice. WTO has set up adjudicatory panel over which country's sugar subsidies after the complaints received from three countries, Australia, Brazil and Guatemala. So the answer here is India's. As per the fourth advance estimates for 2018-19, the total food grain production in the country is estimated at how much? So we are talking about the fourth advance estimates for the year 2018-19, total food production. Okay. So here it is 284.95 million tons. So as per the fourth advance estimates for 2018-19, the total pulses production during 18-19 is estimated at how much? So here we are talking about the pulses production. So the right answer here is 23.40 million tons. This is regarding the pulses. Next, Meghalaya Cabinet has approved an ambitious piggery and livestock mission 2022, which is aimed at benefiting nearly 2 lakh families at a cost of over how much? So the right answer here is ₹1,088 crore. Next, the dairy federations like Amul and Mother Dairy have been encouraged to reuse the plastic milk pouches in a campaign mode with Dash. So what is it? Which strategy is it? You can see the options there. So right one is a 3R strategy. So here you can see it is reduce, rebate and reuse. Okay, so reduce consumption of plastics by subsidizing price of 1 liter pack over half liter pack, rebate to customers for bringing back plastic, reuse of pouches for users such as road construction and recyclers. Kisan Brigade is a farmer welfare organization of which state? I'll talk about Kisan Brigade. The answer is Maharashtra. Agriculture Entrepreneurship Promotion Scheme launched by Odisha government will be beneficial to around how many small and marginal farmers to enhance their income in 3 years? So the right answer here is 2 lakh. Recently, during August 2019, National Center of Organic Farming, NCOF, Ghaziabad has developed a product which is called what? So the right answer is waste decomposer. Which agriculture university has developed a new vetiver variety for soil conservation? So the right answer here is Kerala Agricultural University. Ishwar recently developed by the students of IIT Kanpur is related to which department? So the right answer is irrigation. Which of the following has recently got the geographical indication tag from the state of Kerala? So the right answer is betel leaf. Which state aims to double the cargo values to ₹17,571 crore in maiden farm export policy? The right answer is Uttar Pradesh. The Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has given its approval for providing a lump sum export subsidy of how much to sugar mills for the sugar season 2019-20? So the answer is ₹10,448 per metric ton. The Union Cabinet has approved signing of agreement between India and which country on cooperation in the field of medicinal plants? And the right answer is Peru. As per the third advanced estimates, total horticulture production of the country is estimated to be how much? We are talking about the horticulture production here. So the answer is 313.85 million tons. In the last 5 years, how many global agri-tech companies have ventured in India as compared to more than 25 Indian agri-tech companies with global presence? So the answer is more than 5. Government-owned agriculture insurance company is planning to launch crop reinsurance services abroad, particularly in which countries? So the right answer here is Uttar Pradesh. Okay, so there is some mistake in the answer. I'll just check this answer and give you the correct one. Okay, so the 90th question, if you guys know the answer, you can just put that in the chat section below. There's some mistake with the answer out here. So which countries is a government-owned agriculture insurance company going to launch the crop reinsurance services? I believe it is all, but let me check with the answer. Okay. Next, Walmart Foundation has announced grants of about 34 crore, okay, as part of its long-term commitments to support initiatives that focus on improving. Improving what? Okay. So that is your question. So the right answer here is farmers' livelihood. Which state has signed an agreement with the Chennai-based Central Institute of Brackish Water Aquaculture to boost farmed fish production? So the answer is Maharashtra. This is an important one. Next, the waste decomposer developed by National Center of Organic Farming, NCOF, Ghaziabad works as what? So the right answer is all of these. Okay, so the waste decomposer works even as a soil health reviver, for biocontrol, as a biofertilizer, radiometer. So the answer is all of these. as per the fourth advanced estimates of production of major crops for 18-19, total production of rice during 18-19 is estimated at what? So the answer is 116.42 million tons. Recently, during August 2019, National Center of Organic Farming, Ghaziabad, has developed a product which is named what? We have just now seen this. So you need to tell me the answer very quickly. So answer is waste decomposer. It is the same that we have seen. As per the sugar export policy, for sugar season 19-20, the season end stock are expected to be about how much? So the right answer is 162 lakh metric ton. The Directorate General of Trade Remedies has recommended increase in the rate of customs duty by how much percent on imports of two varieties of palmoline oil originating in Malaysia? So the right answer is 5%. The first ever India International Cooperatives Trade Fair was held at which place? So we are talking about the first ever India International Cooperatives Trade Fair. So the right answer is New Delhi. The cooperative sector has a big role to play in doubling the agriculture exports from present $30 billion to how much by the year 2022? So the right answer is $60 billion. The Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare has signed a statement of intent with IBM India Private Limited for undertaking a pilot study in which of the following three districts? So the right answer is Bhopal, Rajkot and Nanded. Next, when do IBM is planning to conduct a pilot study to utilize artificial intelligence and weather technology solutions in agriculture? So the right answer is Kharif crop season 2019. At the meeting of the Niti Aayog's governing council, central ministers and the state chief ministers have discussed ways of boosting manufacturing activities and exports to realize the goal of the Indian economy to expand to how much? This is again very important. So the right one here is $5 trillion economy by the year 2024. So NARAMAC stands for what? So what is the full form for this particular abbreviation that you can see on your screens? So the right one is Northeastern Region Agricultural Marketing Corporation. So APIDA and NARAMAC have organized a second conference come international buyers sellers meet at which place? So the right answer is Imphal. The first international buyer sellers meet for Northeast region was organized by which organization? So the right answer is APIDA. APIDA functions under which of the following ministry? So it functions under the Ministry of Commerce and Industries. Animal vaccine maker BioVet has announced to invest how much money for its expansion and to tackle FMT and brucellosis in animals? So the right one here is 200 crore. FMT brings down the milk production in cattle, buffaloes and sheep by how much percentage? So the right answer is 80%. This is how it affects. The Tea Association of India release has noted that between 2008 and 2018, tea prices have increased by about how much? So So the answer is 4.8% CAGR. The International Seed Testing Association is to hold its 32nd Congress in which state? So we are talking about the International Seed Testing Association. The answer is Hyderabad. Which state farmers have also joined the movement for genetically modified crops and extend their support to Maharashtra's farmers? This is important. So have a look at this particular question, friends. It is regarding the movement for the genetically modified crops. So the answer is Haryana, wherein these farmers are protesting and saying that they have the right to go for the GM crops or cultivating them. BT cotton was created by adding genes derived from which soil bacterium? So HTBT cotton was something that was in news, and it is herbicide BT cotton. So BT cotton is one of the genetically modified crop. So the answer is Bacillus thuringiensis, the soil bacterium. Agri Intex is a trade fair organized by Codicia in association with which university? Okay, so we are talking about a trade fair, Agri Intex. So the right answer is Tamil Nadu Agricultural University. Government prepared a roadmap for the amalgamation of regional rural banks within a state to bring down the number of RRBs from 56 to how much? So in your syllabus, you also have a special reference to rural banking. Okay, so RRBs are should be brought down from 56 to how many? So the answer is 38. Okay, from 56 to 38. Which two states have initiated moves to amalgamate their district cooperative central bank with the state cooperative banks? So the answer is Kerala and Punjab. Type of weather modification that aims to change the amount or type of precipitation that falls from clouds is called what? So it is known as cloud seeding. The announcement of setting up of a high level task force to bring structural reforms in agriculture in the country was made in which meeting of the Government Council of Niti Aayog? So the right answer here is 5th. Which of the following agri-tech startups has been facilitated by NABARD on its 30th foundation day? So it's important here, wherein you are recognizing the important initiatives being taken up in the agricultural sector. So the answer is all of the above. The name of the startup fund set up by NABARD as an agri-tech, agriculture, rural business and food-focused early to mid-stage startup fund is what? So this is a very important question, guys. So please star mark this. So it is called NAB Ventures basically. Which state government has begun the procurement of copra at enhanced rate under price support scheme for the 2019 season following approval from the center? So the right answer is Tamil Nadu. India's marine fish production has fallen down by how much percentage in the year 2018 against the previous year? So the right answer is 9%. There is a drop by 9%. The groundwater resources constitute how much percentage of India's water supply? The answer is 40%. Finance Minister Srimati Nirmala Sitaram has announced that to all rural households will be provided piped water connections under the Jal Jeevan Mission by which year? So the answer is by the year 2024. Which country asked the WTO to set up a panel for sugar-related dispute against India to probe if India was breaching its obligations? The right answer is Australia. So Kerala Samruddha Keralam project. I'm really sorry, I'm not able to pronounce it. It was recently launched in Kerala. It is related to which crop? So the right answer is coconut. According to the Agriculture Ministry data, 2019 area sown under the kharif crops came down by how much percentage? So this is important. Okay, so this particular data point needs to be remembered. So the right answer is 27%. Foreign direct investment in India in the agriculture sector have gone up from $17.46 million in 2014-15 to how much in the year 2018-19? So the right one here is $40.55 million. Which state government has approved Mukhyamantri Shashwat Krushi Sinchai Yojana or Sinchan Yojana? So it's called Chief Minister's Assured Agriculture Irrigation Scheme. So the right answer is Maharashtra. Next, how many taluks have been selected for the implementation of Chief Minister's Assured Agriculture Irrigation Scheme? So the answer here, it is 251. NABARD plans to infuse how much amount of money to fund around 100 agricultural and rural startups during 2019-20? So the answer is 1000 crore. National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development. So National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development has announced that it will raise how much long-term funds through non-convertible debentures in the current financial year? So the right answer is rupees 60,000 crore. According to the Tamil Nadu government, how much loans amount will be granted through NAB Kisan Finance Limited, which is a subsidiary of NABARD for the benefit of farmer producer organizations? So the right answer is 266 crore. As per the Botanical Survey of India report 2019, the highest number of orchid species is recorded from which state? So we are talking about the highest number of orchid species. So the right answer is Andhra Pradesh. Agribusiness Incubation Center has been started in which state? So the right answer is Chhattisgarh. In November 2017, government has approved continuation of Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana as Rashtriya Krishi Vikas. Okay, this is something. Okay, so there is a modification in the name of the scheme. Okay, so you need to tell me what is the new name. Okay, the same scheme has been continued as what? It has been continued as Raftar. Okay, so Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana Raftar, that is the new name that is being given here. You can have a look at it. As part of Project Goshala, the MP government plans to build how many shelters for cows and bulls close to villages? So the answer is 1000. Which among the following is a very important feature of zero budget natural farming? This is important. This is in news very frequently in regarding zero budget natural farming. And the answer is intercropping. Under the Deen Dayal Antyodaya Yojana National Rural Livelihoods Mission, revolving funds provided per self-help group is how much? So we are talking about per self-help group, that is very important. So the answer is rupees 10,000 to 15,000 per self-help group. How much percentage of country's annual sugar consumption goes into commercial use? The right answer here is 10%. Bangladesh scientists have developed a method to convert jute fiber into low-cost biodegradable cellulose sheets. These cellulose sheets are named as what? The right answer is Sonali. Okay, so mark this question, it's a little different. One of the reasons for antibiotic resistance in India is due to unwanted use of what in the poultry industry? So the answer is colistin. The government has approved an outlay of how much money for 2019-20 for the implementation of agriculture export policy? So the right answer is 206.8 crore. Iker Indian Institute of Water Management with which university jointly organized 3 days chief scientist meet of All India Coordinated Research Project on Irrigation Water Management? The right answer is Indira Gandhi Krishi Vishwavidyalaya, Raipur. Okay. Which state government has stopped implementing the central scheme on crop insurance, PMFBY, from Kharif 2019 and instead rolled out its own scheme? So the right answer is West Bengal. Workshop on quality milk program was held on 25th July 2019 at which place? The right answer is it was held at New Delhi. India's dairy sector grew at an annual rate of how much percentage in the last 4 years? Okay, so this is important. So it is 6.4%. Which of the following institute won prestigious Sardar Patel Outstanding Iker Institution Award 2018? So the right one here is Central Institute of Fisheries Technology. Pradhan Mantri Kisan Urja Suraksha Evam Uttam Mahabhiyan Scheme for Farmers has been launched by which ministry? So the right answer is Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. Recently, central government has extended the PM Kisan scheme. Now, which of the following is a new criteria of size of land holdings under which all the farmers are covered? So this is important, guys. Initially, it was up to 2 hectares and then now there's a revision in the eligibility criteria. So the answer is none of the above. Okay, so they're not going to restrict the criteria now like earlier part. According to the second advanced estimates of area and production of various horticulture crops, which of the following is the estimated production? Okay, so this can be skipped because we saw a current affairs based question. So this one can be skipped here. Okay, the same thing here as well. Okay, yeah, this is important. So which of the following countries has recently lifted the ban imposed on the import of fruits and vegetables from Kerala? This is important. So this particular question, you can just note, it is Saudi Arabia. Okay, so this can be again skipped. So I'm just skipping the questions which have become irrelevant now. You don't need to have a look at these questions. Okay, this is important now. So, in which of the following cities, the 10th annual group meeting of All India Network Research Project on Onion and Garlic was held in the month of June 2019? Okay, so this was an important meet that took place. So, the correct answer here is New Delhi. Which of the following states launched Rai Tu Bandhu scheme for farmers in May 2018? This is important. The answer is Telangana. So Raitu Bandhu scheme, very famous out there. Recently, the state government has increased the support to farmer under Raitu Bandhu scheme. So what is the increased amount that is to be provided to the farmers under this particular scheme? So it is rupees 5,000. So World Food Safety Day is celebrated on which of the following days? It is celebrated on 7th of June. Which of the following organization has developed the first state food safety index? Now, this is again important, 165th question. It is regarding the first state food safety index. It is FSSAI. Which of the following states has launched YSR Raitu Bharosa scheme in the month of June 2019? So it is Andhra Pradesh. Which of the following states has started a cash assistance scheme in order to provide pension to farmers of rupees 6000 per year in addition to the PM Kisan scheme in the month of June 2019? So these are some state related questions. It is important. The answer is Haryana. How much amount the farmers will have to contribute under PM Kisan scheme? So there has to be some contribution done from the farmer's side as well. It is rupees 100 per month. Which of the following organization has constituted the Eat Rights Awards? So the right answer is FSSAI. So recently, which of the following devices has been launched by Dr. Harshvardhan, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, that performs rapid detection of economically driven adulteration in edible oils, fats and ghee? So this is important. Again, star mark this question, guys. So it is Raman 1.0. So recently, which of the following food testing kits was launched by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, which can help in checking the food adulterants? This is again important. So the answer is Food Safety Magic Box. So recently, Punjab Energy Development Agency has signed MOU with which of the following organization to help in transformation of villages of Punjab? So the answer is NABARD. Which of the following states poultry farmers has demanded agriculture status under Income Tax Act in the month of June 2019? The answer is Karnataka. The central government has promised to provide seed traceability software by Dash that can trace the origin of seed. Now this is something very unique. Right answer is June 2020. Which of the following regions has emerged as the largest importer of turmeric from India in the year 2018 as announced by TPCI in the month of June 2019? So the right answer is North America. Which of the following states has started to prepare database on seed growers as announced in the month of June 2019? So the answer is Telangana. Which state has observed a maximum decrease in cattle population? Now these are some of the 10-12 questions taken from your livestock census. Okay, so you can have a look at these questions. The answer here is Gujarat. Okay, so Gujarat has observed a maximum decrease in cattle population. How much is the total livestock population of India as per the 20th livestock census? So yesterday also we had discussed this. It is 536 million. How much is the total bovine population of India as per the 20th livestock census? So the answer is 303 million. How much is the share of goat to the total livestock population of India? So these questions are taken from the recent census. Yes, it is the recent census, 20th livestock census. So the answer here is 28%. How much is the population of poultry in India as per the 20th livestock census? Now, because this has been released very recently in the month of October, it becomes important. So the answer is 852. Which state of India ranks first in poultry population? The answer is Tamil Nadu. How much is the total milk cattle in the India as per the 20th livestock census? So the correct one is 74 million. Which of the following is the leading state in buffalo population in India? Right answer is Uttar Pradesh. How much is the sheep population in millions in India? The right answer is 74. Which state is a leading population is leading in the population of goats in India? So the right answer is Rajasthan. So guys, these last few questions are very important. Okay, so please make sure you are revising them. Which of the following population has shown overall decrease as per the previous census, that is 2012? And the answer is pig. By how much percentage the high milk yielding exotic crossbred cattle population have increased compared to the previous census? And the answer is 32%. So now this is the last question for today. So in which of the following states Mithun, an important bovine species, is found? Okay, this is very popular. So the right answer is both 1 and 3, that is Mizoram and Arunachal Pradesh. So guys, yes, with this we have completed some important questions, nearly 190 out of it, some 10-12 questions were not needed. So 180 questions we have revised, and these are important for your general awareness section that is going to be there in your paper tomorrow, with special focus on agriculture and rural development, right? So it's a bovine species basically, and it is found in mostly, you can say, northeastern states. Okay, it's a gaur species. Fine guys, so with this we are done with today's session, and I really hope that you guys would get some important questions from this in tomorrow's paper. And it would be great if you guys can share the questions that were there in your paper tomorrow by just dropping us a mail at hello@edutap.co.in. Okay. And thank you so much, Jayakrishnan, for this particular comment. We tried our best to come out with the questions that can be useful for you for tomorrow's examination. Right. And thank you so much, NABVenture, for joining in. And all those who are there, I can see few names continuously being there from the start. So Jayakrishnan, Surya Prasad, I can see Shobhudip also, and then Vidya Lux, and there was Vinita, I think. Yes. So all these people, thank you so much for joining in. It was a pleasure to have you all here. If you have any other doubt, you can also call us at 814-620-7241, right? So all the best guys for your tomorrow's examination. Do well, and please do share your results with us. Okay, it will be really great to know how did you do the paper. Okay, Surya Prasad, you can actually find those stats very easily on PIB, okay? And the latest ones you can get on through this PPT as well. We'll also be providing the PDF of this particular sessions on the Telegram channel of EduTap. You can go and download there as well, okay? So thank you so much guys for joining in, and all the best again for tomorrow's paper. Do not be nervous, be on time tomorrow for your examination, right? And make sure you take your admit cards and everything is in place. See your center previously where it is. Do not rush at the last moment. So these are some of the important pointers. So whatever happens, it's going to happen for a reason. So do not worry, and all the best, right?